Master Gardeners. This morning I was down here swimming with my dog, and I noticed there's a lot of foam down here on the along the river accumulated against the rocks. So I was kind of curious, why would foam accumulate, and is that an indicator of pollution? And after researching and looking it up, since I'm not a watershed specialist, I learned that that foam is a naturally occurring substance. And the reason that it occurs is there's a lot of organic matter that's breaking down in the water, and as that organic matter breaks down, it changes the surface tension on the water. You know, water droplets love to stick together. Those water molecules attract one another. That's why on the top of your car, the water beads up into little circles, because the molecules stick together. And it's that surface tension that kind of creates a skim on the surface of the water. And that's how the water striders can walk across the top of the water and not fall in. So surface tension is a natural occurrence on all your water. So what can happen when there's a lot of organic matter that's breaking down in the stream, like leaves and sticks, or even algae that might be breaking down? And it, that organic matter can change the surface tension. And it changes it a sufficient amount that air is able to get into the water. And of course, as air is incorporated into the water, then you can get foam occurring, which is what we have occurring back here. So when does this occur? Oftentimes in the spring, when there's lots of leaves or buds and things that are falling in the stream, there's more algae growing because it's warmer water. It can occur in the fall when there's lots of leaves falling. So here I am in January in Maryland. Why is it occurring now? Well, we had a rain event yesterday. So it's not unusual for it to occur when there's erosion and different things that have gotten into the water and it's turbulence and stirring it up a little bit more than usual. So you look at that and you say, well, how would I know if it was bad pollution or good pollution? By looking at it, we'll look at it a little closer in a second, but it's brown, like a light tan color. And if you were to smell it, it smells kind of fishy or kind of grassy-like, like decomposing things. Those are indications that that's kind of a healthy foam. And also you look around and see if there's any kind of discharge pipes or something, something that would be discharging detergents or cosmetics into the water. And here I am out in the country, so there's no way there's anything really discharging on this. We're at the birthing early parts of the Little Gunpowder River, so that would not be the case right down in here. So that way, that's how I kind of know that that's a positive, a good foam that's occurring. Usually within a week, it usually goes away. If I'm down here swimming with my doggy and it's still there, it's not toxic. I'll just sweep it away and it'll scoot on downstream. So it's not necessarily a bad thing. Back in World War II, we didn't know that we should have biodegradable detergents. And back then, a lot of the detergents were present. And when that foam occurs from, it's a pollutant, you might smell it kind of perfumey, and the color is often pure white. But since World War II, we've changed our detergents, and they're lower in phosphorus now, because phosphorus was used to soften water, but now they're lower phosphorus. So unlikely that most of the pollutants are, they're probably not in most of the water that you're looking at, unless you're near a metro area. So there you go, there's some little tips on surfactants and how they work. If you're a watershed specialist, you would refer to this as dissolved organic organic matter or organic carbon. DOCs is the word that they use for these dissolved organic matter in the water. But come on over, you can take a look. I'll show you the foam up close. Well, not too close, because I'm not gonna walk in the water completely. But there it is, you can see the brown on the surface of it. Definitely a brown color. So it's a pretty, there goes my doggy. Come on, Lou, come on. So there you go, and here's the ripples. This is the turbulence, that's all it takes. You can see those pretty ripples, I'm sure you can hear it in here. So enjoy that. So there you go, Master Gardeners, have a good day.